and the Lord's revelation of Jnana Yoga. The scene starts with Lord Krishna, the divine charioteer, driving the chariot for Arjuna and placing it before the two armies of Pandavas and Kauravas. Krishna commands Arjuna to worship Goddess Durga, the giver of victory in war. Arjuna sees that the enemy ranks are full of his own relatives. He is affected by sentimentality and refuses to wage war. Like the typical confused man evading his duty and philosophizing the same, Arjuna laments to Krishna thus: "What pleasure can we derive by killing the sons of Dhritarashtra? We will only be accruing sin by killing our cousins. They are blinded by greed and are not perceiving the evil of destruction of our family. They are not bothered about accruing sin through committing injustice to friends. But Krishna, why should we not turn away from this crime? It would be better for me if the sons of Dhritarashtra killed me in the battlefield while I was unarmed and unresisting." Bhagavan Krishna says, "How did you get abominably confused like an uncultured fellow at this odd hour? This will neither bring you heaven for the other world nor fame for this world." Arjuna asks, "Madhusudana, how can I shoot my arrows at our worshipful Bhishma and Drona and fight against them? My mind is tainted with faint-heartedness. I am puzzled as to what is dharma. I plead with you, tell me what is decidedly correct. I am your disciple. I pray to you to instruct me, for I have sought refuge in you." Bhagavan Krishna explains, "Arjuna, all beings were unmanifest before they were born. They are manifest with form in the intermediate stage. They will all become unmanifest when they die. So, where is the need to lament? Just as a man discards worn-out clothes and takes new ones, the soul casts off the worn-out bodies and enters into new ones. The soul cannot be cut by weapons. Fire cannot burn it. Water cannot drench it. Nor can wind dry it. Moreover, considering the Kshatriya Dharma, you cannot afford to waver, for there is nothing greater for a warrior than waging a righteous war. Treating alike pleasure and pain, gain and loss, victory and defeat with equanimity, get ready to fight. Such a mentality will not bring you sin. If one performs physical actions with a mind and body that have been subdued enough to give up craving for all subjects of enjoyment, he does not incur sin." Arjuna asks, "O Keshava, what are the characteristics of a man of steady wisdom? How does he speak, sit, and walk?" Bhagavan Krishna explains, "O Partha, when one thoroughly abandons all desires and enjoys self-contentment, he is a man of steady mind. If one's mind remains unperturbed in sorrow and happiness, with his thirst for pleasure altogether disappeared and is also free from passion, fear, and anger, he is called a sage. Like the tortoise drawing its limbs within itself from all directions, when a man withdraws his senses from sense objects, he is called a man of steady wisdom. With the mind set on sense objects, man develops attachment to them. From attachment arises desire. From unfulfilled desire springs up anger. From anger is born infatuation. Infatuation leads to confusion in memory. This in turn develops destruction of the intellect. And with loss of reason, one invites complete ruin. The ocean which receives water from the rivers from all sides remains undisturbed. Likewise, a man of steady wisdom is at peace with himself, even while all enjoyments merge in him, for he is not the one who hankers after pleasures. Arjuna, you and I have passed through many a birth. I know them all while you do not. Whenever there is a decline in righteousness, an unrighteousness is in the ascent. I physically manifest myself for the protection of the good and destruction of the evil doers, and for the establishment of dharma. I am born age after age. That is scene one of Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna's confusion, his surrender to Krishna as disciple, and the Lord's revelation of Jnana Yoga. Dear friends, just before we commence the program, kindly note that we strictly do not permit any audio or video recording in any format of this program, and please keep all your mobile phones either in silent or switched off mode. And we'll be grateful for your kind cooperation in the smooth conduct of the program. And we are doubly delighted to devotionally dedicate this Bhagavad Gita program at the lotus feet of Pujya Shri Swami Dayananda Saraswati, who is Dr. Padma's mentor for over 4 decades. And he blessed her with his presence during the first program of Bhagavad Gita right here in Narada Gana Sabha Hall. Bhagavad Gita.
Beep, 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 beep. Janardana, Janardana, Janardana. Arjuna. Kutastva kashmalamidam vishame samupasthitam anaryajushtam aswargyo akirtikaram. Arjuna, Madhusudana, Hari Sudana, Katham.
शरीराणि विहाय
ಪಾಂಡವಾನಿ ದೇಹಿ ನೈನಂ ಚಿಂತಂತಿ ಶಸ್ತ್ರಾಣಿ ನೈನಂ ದಹತಿ ಪಾವಕಃ ನ ಚೈನ ಕ್ಲೇದಯಂತ್ಯಾಪೋ ನ ಶೋಯಯತಿ ಮಾರುತಃ ಸ್ವಧರ್ಮಮಪಿ ಚಾವೇಕ್ಷ ನ ವೀಕಂ ನ ವಿದ್ಯತೆ ಸುಖ ದುಃಖೆ ಸಮೇ ಕೃತ್ವಾ ಸುಖ ದುಃಖೆ ಸಮೇ ಕೃತ್ವಾ ಲಾಭಾ ಲಾಭೌ ಜಯಾ ಜಯೌ ತತೋ ಯುತಾಯ ಯೋಜಸ್ವ ನೈವಂ ಪಾಪಮಪಾಸ್ಯಸಿ ನಿರಾಶೀರ್ಯತ ಚಿತ್ತಾತ್ಮಾ ತತ್ತಂ ಸರ್ವ ಪರಿಗ್ರಹ ಶಾರೀರಂ ಕೇವಲಂ ಕರ್ಮ ಕುರ್ವನ್ ನ ಆಪ್ನೋತಿ ಕಿಲ್ಬಿಷಂ ನಿಸಮಾಗಪಾಮಗಮಸ ಸಪಾಪಮಾಮಮಾಮರೇರಸ ಪ್ರಭಾಷೇತ ಕಿಂ ಆಸೀತ ವ್ರಜೇತ ಕಿಂ ಪ್ರಜಾತಿ ಯದಾ ಕಾಮಾ ಸರ್ವಾನ್ ಪಾತ ಮನೋಗತಾನ್ ಪ್ರಜಾತಿ ಯದಾ ಕಾಮಾ ಸರ್ವಾನ್ ಪಾತ ಮನೋಗತಾನ್ ಆತ್ಮನಿ ಆತ್ಮನಾತುಷ್ಟಃ ಸ್ಥಿತ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಸ್ತದೋಚತೆ
ತಡಿಂಗು ತಕ 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 ತಡಿಂಗ
bhavati sammohah sammohat smriti vibhramah smriti bhramshat buddhi nasho buddhi nashat vinashyati apuryamanam achal pratishtam samudramapah pravishanti tatvatamaya pravishanti sarve Sanshanti mapnoti na kam kami.
Dhanudhanam taritukun taritika taka ta 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 di ta ta di ta ta di taritika dumta chanudhanam taritukun taritika taka ta 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 di ta ta di ta ta di ದುಂಧಾಣುತನಂ ತರಿತಾದಾದಿ ತರಿಕಿಟ ದುಂಧ ಚಣುತನಂ ತರಿತಾದಾದಾದಿ ತರಿಕಿಟ ದುಂಧಾಣುತನಂ ಕಿಡದ ತಿಮಿದ ತಗು ತರಿಕಿಟ ದುಂಧ ಚಣುತನಂ ಕಿಡದ ತಿಮಿದ ತಗು ತರಿಕಿಟ ದುಂಧಾದಿ ಸಚಂ ಕಣಂ ಕರಂಗ ತಿಂಕೃದುಂ ಸಚಂ ಕಣಂ ಕರಂಗ ತಿಂಕೃದುಂ ಸಚಂ ಕಣಂ ಕರಂಗ ತಿಂಕೃದುಂ
ಬಹುನಿ ಮೇ ವ್ಯಗೀತಾನಿ ಜನ್ಮಾನಿದವಜ ಅರ್ಜುನ Arjuna Arjuna Bahuni me vyagidani janmani tavach Arjuna Bahuni me vyagidani janmani tavach Arjuna tanyaham veda sarvani Natvam veta parantapa Tanyaham veda sarvani Natvam veta parantapa Yada yada hi dharmasya Jani bhavati bharata Yada yada hi dharmasya Jani bhavati bharata Adharmasya Tadatmanam Srijamyaham Abhyuttanam Adharmasya Tadatmanam Srijamyaham Paritranaya Sadhunam Vinashaya Chat Shambhava.
Scene 2, Karma Yoga. Arjuna intervenes, O Keshava, if you consider jnana, that is wisdom, to be greater than karma, that is action, why then do you urge me to do this awful action? Bhagavan Krishna says, O sinless one, in this world, two courses of spiritual disciplines, that is sadhana, have been enunciated by me in the past. The sadhana is evolved in the path of jnana for the Sankhya yogi, and it is processed through the path of karma in the case of the karma yogi. You have a right only to do your duty, but not over the fruit of your action. Let not the fruit of the action be your goal, nor should you be attached to inaction. He who sees inaction in action and action in inaction is wise among men. He is a yogi who has accomplished all actions. O Dhananjaya, relinquishing attachment and maintaining indifference to success and failure, keep performing your duty. Equanimity is called yoga. Therefore, perform your allotted duty. Action is superior to inaction. By desisting from action, you cannot even maintain your physical well-being. At the beginning of creation, while creating mankind along with yajna, that is Vedic rite, Prajapati, the lord of mankind, said to them thus, may your tribe increase through yajna. May yajna yield the enjoyment you seek. Foster the devas, that is forces of nature, through yajna, and may the devas foster you through their blessing, thus mutually satisfying and fostering one another, you will attain the highest good. All beings are evolved from food. Production of food depends on rain. Rain ensues from yajna, and yajna is rooted in karma, that is action. Know that karma has its origin in the Vedas, and Vedas proceeded from the eternal God. Hence, the all-pervading infinite is always present in the yajna. O Partha, this wheel of creation activates the world through performance of allotted duty. He who does not turn this wheel lives in vain a mere sinful, sensual life. Yajna is performed in varied ways by varied people. It may be offering material things, performing penance, observance of yoga and austere vows, and through study of text relating to wisdom to attain peace within oneself. Many forms of yajna are known from the Vedas. They are all obtained through action of the body, mind and senses. A knowledge of these frees you from the bondage of karma. Now, hear how one can attain siddhi, that is realization, by being devoted to one's own duty. Man attains siddhi through performing the allotted work, as worship of that Supreme from whom all beings emanate and by whom all this creation is pervaded, that is seen to Karma Yoga.
Shreera Yatra Pichane Na Prasiddhaye
Pravati Pajanyo Yajna Karma Sambhavah Karma Brahmodbhavam Vidhi Brahma Akshara Samudbhavam Tasmat Sarvagatam Brahma Nityam Yajne Pratishtitam Evam Pravatitam Chakram Evam Pravatitam Chakram Evam Pravatitam Chakram Nanuvartayati Iha Yaha Evam Pravatitam Chakram Nanuvartayati Iha Yaha Agayurindriya Ramo Mokham Sajivati Partha Sajivati Sajivati Sajivati
Okay.
ततः सिद्धिं यथा विन्दति तच्छृणु सिद्धिं विन्दति मानवः स्वकर्मणा तमप्यज्य तत्तं स्वकर्मणा तमप्यज्य सिद्धिं विन्दति मानवः यतः प्रवृत्तिभूतानां येन सर्वमिदं यतः प्रवृत्तिभूतानां येन सर्वमिदं 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 तत्तं 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 स्वकर्मणा तमप्यज्य सिद्धिं विन्दति मानवः सिद्धिं विन्दति मानवः सिद्धिं विन्दति मानवः स्वकर्मणा तमप्यज्य तत्तं 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 स्वकर्मणा तमप्यज्य
Scene 3, Prakriti and Bhakti Yoga. Bhagavan Krishna says, I shall explain to you something after knowing which there is nothing else to be still known in this world. It is jnana in its entirety, along with the knowledge of manifest divinity. My prakriti, nature, is eightfold, that is, earth, water, fire, air, space, mind, intellect, and ego. This is my apara prakriti, that is, lower insentient nature. My para, or higher sentient nature, by which the whole universe is sustained, is in the form of jiva, that is, life principle. Understand that all beings have evolved from this twofold prakriti. I am the source of this creation. It will all dissolve back into me. My prakriti, in primordial underdeveloped state, is the womb of all creatures. I place my seed, that is, of consciousness, into that womb. O descendant of Bharata, the birth of all beings follows from this combination of matter and spirit. O son of Kunti, Prakriti is the mother, and I am the father of all the beings who take birth from the respective wombs. The Jivatma, soul, in the body, is an immortal part of my own self. It draws the five senses and the mind from the rest of the matter. When the soul migrates into another body, these six are carried away with it, just like the wind snatching away the fragrance from the flowers. This Jivatma enjoys the objects of the senses while dwelling in the body. Sattva, Rajas, and Tamas are the three qualities born from Prakriti, and they tie the imperishable soul to the body. Sattva binds the jiva with the body through self-identification with bliss and wisdom, because Sattva is immaculate, illuminating, and flawless. Rajas binds the jiva with the body through attachment to the fruits of action, for it is of the nature of passion born of cupidity. Tamas is the deluder in all embodied beings. It is born of ignorance. It binds the soul to the body through error, sloth, and sleep. When a person dies during the preponderance of sattva, he attains faultless worlds gained by men of noble deeds. Dying when Rajas is an ascendant, he is born to those attached to action. Likewise, expiring during the preponderance of Tamas, he is born in the wombs of stupid creatures. He who worships me through Bhakti Yoga transcends the three gunas and becomes eligible to attain Brahman. I personally appear in front of the disinterested devotee of purified intellect and delightfully partake the article offered by him to me with love. It may just be a leaf, a flower, a fruit, or just water. The indestructible unmanifest is called the supreme goal. That is my abode, reaching which man will not return. O Partha, it is only through bhakti that one can reach the supreme Purusha, in whom all beings reside and by whom all this is pervaded. That is scene 3, Prakriti and Bhakti Yoga.
ज्ञानं तेयहं सविज्ञानमिदम्।
Okay.
जीव भूतः सनातनः मनः षष्ठानि वाप्नोति यच्चापि उत्क्रामति ईश्वरः शरीरं यदवाप्नोति यच्चापि उत्क्रामति ईश्वरः गृहीत्वा एतानि संयाति वायु गन्धानिव
सर्वदेहिना
tamastu ajnanajam vidhi mohanam sarvadehina pramada alasya nidra bhistanni badnati bharata
Tadaham bhakti bhuta hritam ashnami prayatatmanah
we come to the fourth scene, that is the concluding sequence of this program. The Lord's assurance and cosmic revelation. Arjuna says that his mind is uncontrollable like the wind, and Krishna assures him that it would be possible to control it through practice and conviction. Arjuna asked Krishna a pertinent question. In spite of having faith and practice in yoga, if there is a failure in his attainments due to slips in controlling the mind, what would be the consequence and what would be his fate? Krishna assures him that none of his devotees would be left in lurch. Even if he is the worst sinner, he is redeemed like a good man, for he would have started in the right path. Women, Vaishyas, Shudras, and even those born of sin will attain mukti if they worship him. After listening to his assurance, Arjuna pleads with Krishna to reveal his cosmic form. When Krishna graciously obliges him, Arjuna not only has a vision of the whole cosmos, but also witnesses the terrible sight of the host of warriors along with Bhishma, Drona and Karna gushing into the terrible form of the Lord. Some of their heads are seen getting powdered by being caught inside his terrible teeth. Unable to bear this awesome sight, Arjuna pleads with the Lord to reveal his name and purpose. The Lord replies that he is Kala, or time, who has come to consume the world. He says that he has already killed those soldiers and they would have been killed even without the presence of Arjuna. The Lord says to Arjuna, "You are just an instrument in my hands. Rise up. Use your bow, take the credit of killing your enemies and enjoy this kingdom." Arjuna recognizes all the forces of nature in the cosmic form of the Lord Almighty. He says, "A thousand prostrations to you, who is the Lord of wind, death and fire. You are the moon, the Lord of mankind, the very originator of life." At the end, Arjuna touchingly pleads with the Lord to pardon him for all the insults that he had caused to the Lord by taking him to be a friend. He says, "I called out your name as Krishna, Yadava, and friend, both inadvertently and knowingly, alone and in the presence of everybody. I misbehaved with you without realizing your glory. May I be pardoned for all the mistakes." The program concludes with Arjuna fighting the battle with divine blessings. That is the concluding scene, the Lord's assurance and cosmic revelation. Dear Rasikas, let us all join together in praying to that Supreme Lord Krishna to bless all of us in this auditorium and those who are not present here and those who are watching this Bhagavad Gita program all over the world through the live webcast through kalakendra.com, to bless all of us, humanity, with a peaceful, prosperous, happy, purposeful and a glorious life. Thank you.
Thank you.
Krishna.
Samyak vyavasito hi saha
साधुरेव समन्तव्यः सम्यक् व्यवसितो हि सः क्षिप्रं भवति धर्मात्मा शश्वत शान्तिं निगच्छति क्षिप्रं भवति धर्मात्मा शश्वत शान्तिं निगच्छति कौन्तेय प्रतिजानीहि न मे भक्तः प्रणश्यति कौन्तेय प्रतिजानीहि न मे भक्तः प्रणश्यति मां हि पात व्यपाश्रित्य येऽपि स्युः पापयोनयः मां हि पात व्यपाश्रित्य येऽपि स्युः पापयोनयः स्त्रियो वैश्यास्तथा शूरास्ते अपि स्त्रियो वैश्यास्तथा
विशेष संघा ब्रह्मानं ईशं कमलासनस्थं ऋषि सर्वा
kalosmi 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 kalosmi
Bye. Mm-hmm. सभं यदुक्तं सखेते मत्वा प्रसभं यदुक्तं हे कृष्णा हे यादवा हे सखे इति सखेति मत्वा प्रसभं यदुक्तं सखेति मत्वा प्रसभं यदुक्तं हे कृष्णा हे यादवा हे सखे इति अजानता महिमानं तवेदं मया अजानता महिमानं तवेदं असाधम असकृतोसि निहार शयासन भोजनेषु निहार शयासन भोजनेषु एको अथवापि अच्युतात्समक्षं तत्क्षामये त्वामहं अप्रमेयं तत्क्षामये त्वामहं अप्रमेयं अच्युत
tarikidata 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 dhim digadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagadagad Thank you.